Richard Strauss. This is the second of the series of Strauss tone poems. Macbeth has never quite caught on in the way that Don Juan has. The first performance of Don Juan in 1889 established the 25-year-old composer once and for all. On the first page of his score, there are three quotations from Lenard's poem, Don Juan, which give no clue to the dramatic episodes in the Don's life. The first two quotations express his desire to run the full gamut of the magic circle of the charms and beauty of women. The second extols the birth and death of each new passion. And the third quotation, near the end of the poem, expresses joy at the life he has led, the life that ends in cold and dark. Despite the message of these quotations, the music fairly clearly depicts two full-blown love scenes, a carnival and a final fatal duel. At the same time, the form is that of a sonata movement with two large episodes in the development section. So now we have Don Juan, tone poem by Richard Strauss.
Thank you.
That performance of Strauss's tone poem Don Juan was given by the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra, conducted by Rudolf Kemper. That was Rudolf Kemper. In a moment or two, you'll hear him give a performance of Tchaikovsky's Sixth Symphony, the Pathétique. Amongst the composer's papers was found a brief note which describes what John Warwick has called Tchaikovsky's Symphony of Defeat, the one in which he finally faces up to the truth about his nature and his failure to master fate, that fate with a capital F that dominates Tchaikovsky's last three symphonies. The note says, "The ultimate essence of the plan of the symphony is life. First part, all impulsive passion, confidence, thirst for activity, must be short. Finale, death, result of collapse. Second part, love. Third, disappointments. Fourth, ends dying away, also short." Thus Tchaikovsky's rough draft about the symphony, and now here it is. Symphony number 6 by Tchaikovsky, Rudolf Kemper conducting the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra.
Tchaikovsky's Symphony No. 6 was performed by the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra, leader Erik Grünberg, conductor Rudolf Kempe. Rudolf Kempe has been artistic director and principal conductor since 1963, and this week Antal Doráty will assume the post. Rudolf Kempe will become conductor of the BBC Symphony Orchestra. He and other members of the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra were heard in this portrait of an orchestra talking to John Amis, who also introduced the programme.